Hello, sis, how are you?
Good, thank you.
That's a good busy day.
Elsie Waia is doing the rounds on the Torres Strait's Saibai Island.
Any issues?
She grew up here and now plays a special role in keeping her community safe.
Engaging with them, just being the bridge between the justice and the community, like educating the community about the Queensland law.
Ms Waia is a Torres Strait Police Liaison Officer, or tiplo as they're known locally. They're the eyes and ears for Queensland Police on 14 remote islands.
They become like tactical intelligence. They sort of just advise us and they keep us updated of how incidents are progressing.
They're often the first to respond to crimes in a region spanning 48,000 square kilometres.
With the experience, you know, sometimes they might have to look after a situation where, you know, we might not be able to respond immediately, or it takes time to organise a helicopter or a boat to get to an island.
It's helped lower crime. The Australian Institute of Criminology found rates of property crime in the Torres Strait were below the state average, and the number of crimes against people, such as assaults, was lower than in Queensland's Aboriginal communities.
Police officers are from those local communities. They speak local languages. They know who people are. They know who to go to when things are occurring in those communities.
Bardu Islander Boyd Armat is one of the newest recruits of 35 officers.
Played like four times for the same position.
What's the most unique thing about policing on Saibai Island?
I guess the view. There's nothing like this anywhere else.
And it offers a sense of pride for both. Marion Farr, ABC News.